Good morning to you, my brothers and sisters all. Those who are coming in, particularly those from the Cathedral Church, the south side transept is almost empty. And that's the coolest part of the church, both south and north transept. Just before we commence the service itself, I want to extend welcome to you all, you who are present, as well as those who have joined us virtually. We gather this morning to celebrate with St Jago High School on the occasion of their 280th anniversary, a wonderful milestone it is. For those who are coming to the cathedral for the first time, let me just point out that the restrooms are outside, one outside this building. Turn left when you go outside. One set is there, the other is at the church hall. If you have to leave, please leave during the service, that is, discreetly. If there's an emergency, we're asking you as much as is possible to exit the building if you have to, quickly, but orderly. Those who are exiting the building at the west, through the west door from the church, we're asking you not to stop in the walkway, but to go straight out into Cathedral Square. The reason for that is, if you stop in the walkway, those who are inside will not be able to get out. Those who are sitting towards the front, there are two exits. One to my left, your right, that's the south side. And there's much space on that side. Don't stop the moment you exit the building. Go into the open space. There's another exit to my right, your left. I'm asking you, do not use that gate onto the main road. That might be dangerous. But turn left the moment you exit the door, and it will take you back to Cathedral Square. Let me hope none of that will be necessary. Finally, if you have parked and you are blocking someone, please go to your vehicle and park it somewhere else. Make sure you don't block anyone. I do not like to make announcements in the middle of the service about cars blocking other cars and someone wants to leave. Let's do it properly. There's enough park in the main car park, so if you are not satisfied, you're not comfortable with the place you have parked, you can leave now and put your vehicle in the main car park. Sufficient space is there for all of us. Let us prepare ourselves for worship.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Gracious God and Father of us all, we give you heartfelt night that has passed, the rest we have received in it, and this new and glorious day, we gather in your name to praise you, for you are our God. We give you thanks for St Jago High School, for its work in the community, for its place in preparing leaders for the nation and for the world. And as we join with them in this act of celebration, we give you thanks, O Lord, for all those who are presently engaged. We open forth our lips to praise you. Incline your ears now to our prayers, our worship, and let your blessing come upon all of us. Hear us, O Lord, as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Oh, Be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love, as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you alone can bring into order the unruly wills and affections of sinners. Grant your people grace to love what you command and desire what you promise, that among the swift and varied changes of the world, our hearts may surely there be fixed where true joys are to be found. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. We'll have the first reading. Let me invite Liana.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 31, reading from verse 31 to 34. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me. From the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord, for I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the Word of God, written in the lesson to the Hebrews chapter 5, reading from verse 5 to 10. So also, Christ did not glorify himself in becoming a high priest, but was appointed by the one who said to him, "You are my son. Today I have begotten you." As he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplication with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered, and having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Having been designated by God a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek." The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to Christ, our Savior.
Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew, and Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life will lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled. And what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No. It is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven saying, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the rulers of the world will be driven out. And I, when I'm lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." Jesus said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, O Lord. Bless thy word unto our hearts and glorify thy name. Bless thy word unto our hearts and glorify thy name.
Let us pray. O God, uphold me that I may acclaim you. May the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be now and always acceptable in your sight as I speak in your name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Sisters and brothers, first of all, let me extend an apology on behalf of the Archbishop, Archbishop Howard Gregory, who was invited to preside and preach at this service. However, he is leading a retreat for persons seeking to discern a vocation in the church out of town, and hence he is unable to be with you today. Nonetheless, he has asked me to convey his best wishes for your celebration, and I'm sure he will be involved as the celebration unfolds. Congratulations to St. Jago High School on this milestone, 280 years. This is wonderful. And is a testimony to the fighting spirit, the resilience, strength of character, and fortitude of your school. In congratulating you on this milestone, I wish to commend you on the wonderful work you are doing and to use this opportunity to encourage you to keep up the good work. As they say, the reward for hard work is more work. Your commemoration of 280 years helps frame the question in the minds of a number of persons, and Anglicans in particular. That is, how can the diocese be celebrating its 200th anniversary this year, and an Anglican institution like St. Jago is older than the diocese? The answer lies in how we understand the history of Jamaica and the Anglican Church in particular. The English captured the island from the Spaniards in 1655 or 1654 and established a presence which carried with it the Church of England that has now evolved into the Diocese of Jamaica and the Cayman Islands. 200 years ago, the diocese was established. That is to say, a bishop was appointed, and the church became an independent institution from the Church of England. Since then, the diocese has been operating independent of the Church of England, and though we maintain cordial relationship with them, we are not the Church of England. We do not fall under their jurisdiction. Nothing they say or do affect us directly, maybe indirectly. They don't give us any money because we're not dependent on them. Some people think so, you know. Some people say, well, how come, you know, you should be richer than what you are now because you should be getting money, pounds, you know. No, we don't get any. Otherwise, we would have given it to St. Jago. At the same time, we belong to the worldwide Anglican Communion, which was established in the 19th century. And this year, in keeping with the 200th anniversary celebration, the Archbishop of Canterbury has agreed to visit the diocese and preach at a service at the National Arena on the 21st of July, to which you are all invited. If his visit wasn't so short, we would make sure that he goes to St. Jago, but he can't. It's too short. This background information, brief though it is useful because as an Anglican school, the brief history I outlined incorporates and involves you. Nevertheless, it also demonstrates your independence and your commitment to forge a process of the development of young people, young minds, and by extension, the development of our country. You, like other Anglican schools and other schools owned by Christian denominations, focus and have been focusing on character education. That is, the emphasis on personal, social, emotional, psychological, spiritual, and the academic life of children in general and those who attend St. Jago in particular. This focus on character education is central to the policy, the mission, and the focus of the Diocese of Jamaica and the Cayman Islands. That is to say, as a church, we exist not simply to proselytize, that is, to make new converts for Christ, but to form persons so they are able to assume their rightful role as critical and creative thinkers who will see themselves as playing a key part in the development of our nation and the world. This, of course, includes sports and other activities which we believe contribute to the development of well-rounded individuals. Your theme of acknowledging the foundation, continuing the legacy, building the future, resonates with the theme for the 200th anniversary of the diocese, which is yesterday, today, tomorrow, celebrating service, guarding justice, affirming hope. In some ways, and without consulting each other in the development of these themes, we are together reflecting on the past, affirming the present, and looking towards the future with hope, optimism, and anticipation of things God has in store for both our institutions. This service this morning, therefore, is an opportunity for us to refocus ourselves, turn the spotlight on the theme, and explore how it is inviting us to reflect on where we have come from and the endless possibilities which still exist in God for your growth and development as an institution, which is vital to the growth and maturity of our nation. So in reflecting on the theme, I have broken it out into three parts: acknowledging the foundation, continuing the legacy, and building the future. Acknowledging the foundation. I came across a story recently which helped me put in perspective what acknowledging the foundation could mean. It is anonymous in that we don't know who wrote it, but it is the story about tools in a workshop arguing with each other about which one is not necessary, is expendable, and therefore cannot remain in the workshop and should be discarded. First, the hammer, which of course was chairing the meeting. He was told to leave the workshop because he made too much noise, disturbing the peace of others. He was prepared to go, but he indicated the screw had to leave as well because it took too many turns for it to be put in place and therefore exacted too much energy from the carpenter. The screw then said, "Yes, I could leave, but the plane has to leave also because it only touched the surface of things and therefore did not go to any great depth in the wood." The plane said if it had to go, then the sandpaper must also leave because it too operated on the surface and always rubbed things the wrong way. As they argued, the carpenter came in to make a door. He used all the tools, including those that were to be discarded, to make the door. And the customer for whom the door was made was extremely satisfied. The tools then regathered and came to the consensus that each one and everyone was essential for the work of the carpenter in his shop. The moral of the story is that everyone is needed for the success of any venture. This reflects the message in the collect for today, which acknowledges that God is able to bring into order the unruly wills and affections of sinners. Which means, without the foundation set by those who have gone before and those who are laboring now at St. Jago, the success of the school would not be what it is today, and the success of the future would not be guaranteed. Furthermore, drawing on the reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah, Jeremiah 31 to 34, we see the prophet calling the people into a covenant relationship with God. This was after they rebelled against God and were sent into exile or into punishment. In the new covenant being proclaimed as they prepared to return to their homeland, they are called upon to focus not on the external things, the external law, the commandments, but on the commandment that is deep within them. That is their capacity, God-given capacity, to do great things in cooperation and collaboration with God. This, for me, goes to the heart of the meaning of education, which is to draw the best out of people. This approach to education is the spirit of covenant or relationship which has God at its heart and is open, willing, and excited to work with all stakeholders, staff, parents, students, and everyone to advance the welfare, the success of the school. So the foundation of St. Jago was built not just with concrete and steel, but with faith, with goodwill, with confidence that the church and the school could collaborate and cooperate to make a positive difference in the society. This is the meaning of covenant. It's a relationship. It recognizes the central role of God if any venture is to succeed. And therefore, what we have as we celebrate this 280th anniversary is a solid foundation on which we are called to build and to pass it on to the generations that are to come, so that 280 years from now, they would be thanking us and those who came before us for the success of this great and noble institution. Let's build on the legacy of the past. So we are to continue the legacy, having acknowledged the foundation of those who built before us. The success of St. Jago means standing on the shoulders of those who came before us. It means cherishing their legacy, thanking them for the hard work and the sacrifices they made. And so we have an opportunity to revisit the honor roll, similar to the writer of the letter to the Hebrews in chapter 11, who recognized the vision and the work of those who came before, and to draw on their spirit and their energy so that we can chart a course forward for the future. This means, prior to establishing the school around the middle of the 18th century, when enslavement was at its peak and would have to wait until just under 100 years before it was abolished. There was at that time a sense of urgency in terms of the education of children. At that time, of course, the vision was not so much for the education of the then predominantly black population. Nevertheless, without knowing the full extent of the future, 280 years later, these fathers and mothers have contributed significantly to our nation's development, and for that we are grateful. We thank them for their legacy. We cannot take this rich legacy for granted. And so the call to obedience, which we read of in the letter to the Hebrews from the reading we listened to earlier, is a call to be obedient to this great heritage and to enable us to shape and reshape the present and the future. Every principal that has served the school, including the present one, Mrs. Price, whose birthday is today, we congratulate her, each brought energy, insight, vitality, faith, and resilience in leading this great and noble institution. With the motto of work conquers all the principals partnered, collaborated, and shared with students, teachers, parents, members of the community, and all stakeholders to continue building on a rich legacy which has enabled St. Jago to stand out as among the best schools, not just in Jamaica and the Caribbean, but in the world. In the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 5, verse 5 to 10, the writer tells us Christ learned obedience through what he suffered. Part of the legacy of St. Jago is to teach us that challenges are not so much obstacles, but they are opportunities for us to build the present and the future. Part of the challenge we face as an institution are lessons to communicate to our students, to say to them, when you are faced with challenges, it is time to redouble your efforts to succeed. I remember one of our sons was going to prep school, and a number of my friends were moving their children from the school and saying, you know, the school was failing. So they asked me if we're not moving our son. I said, no. I said, he must learn that when you face challenges, you must run away. You must face it up front. Deal with it. Because this is a lesson for the future. Are there challenges at St. Jago? Yes, I know, because I am a good friend of the principal. So I know. I haven't been there yet. I promise you I'll be there. But there are a number of challenges. Should we surrender in light of and in the face of these challenges? No. We have to teach the children and the staff and all the stakeholders that with God, all things are possible. So I don't agree with the government using funds from the National Housing Trust to shore up the budget. But I wouldn't have any difficulty if they take some of the money for infrastructure work in schools across the country, and St. Jago in particular. I think I would forgive them if they do that. Because there's no doubt that the infrastructure in schools across the country, and St. Jago in particular, is in a dilapidated state. And while I hear that there are steps being taken to implement the Patterson Report, I think we're moving too slow. And if we're not careful, we could come to another 20, 30 years where the government commissions another study to address the problem. We know what the problems are. What we need are resources. And therefore, this is the call to obedience to the legacy that has been entrusted to us. It's a legacy of optimism, of hope, of building, and charting the way forward. Recognizing, yes, that challenges and obstacles will always face us, but these ought not to define who we are. So we have the legacy, board members, staff members, students, and you here at the cathedral. We have the legacy of this noble school. Let us ensure and do everything in our capacity to ensure that we build on it and hand it on as a greater potential for nation building for the future. We come finally to building the future. We must build with the future in mind. Native Americans have a way of saying, and a philosophy, that they plan not just for the present, but for 10 years down the road. At the present time, many are concerned about what they can get in the immediate. I went to a wedding yesterday in Montego Bay, and I saw something. I saw it for the first time. I've been going to weddings all my life, and I'm almost 60. And for the first time, I saw a collection of money at a wedding. I've never seen it. They have this thing where you put two collection containers before the bride and the groom, and all the guests are supposed to bring money. And so if you like the groom, you put it in the box for the groom. If you like the bride, you put it in the box for the bride. And if you like both, you put it in both. And then the MC says, well, we're giving you some money now, so you can't say that the relationship is broke down because you don't have any money. Now, I don't know how that money is going to last for a long time. But it struck me that we have this very narrow way of looking at things. And we just see what is before us and not for the long term. A long-term relationship needs money, yes, but money can't be that important. So don't get me wrong, St. Jago needs money. But I think we need some goodwill. We need some volunteers. We need some committed stakeholders that are going to ensure and do everything in their power to ensure that we preserve the character and the integrity of this institution for the next 280 years. Jesus puts it this way in the gospel reading. Unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. He goes on to say, whoever serves me must follow me. Where I am, there my servant will be. Jesus is a man of action. A man who lived not just for the present, but for the future. And so he had a growth mindset which inspired his ministry. And so I want to draw from his teaching the importance of service.
Thank you, Principal, board members, students, staff, community representatives, and all stakeholders for the service you have been giving and are giving to the school. Please continue. St. Jago's future is dependent on the foundation already established, the legacy that has been passed on to us. We are not starting at ground zero, therefore. We have an abundance of assets to build on. At its core is the call to service above self. And so as we challenge the government to do more for the sake of education in this country, and as we challenge ourselves as church to increase our partnership with government and the schools for the future of our children, we must also include our ecumenical brothers and sisters as we carry forward this good work that those who came before us began. So finally, in the story I told earlier, all the tools were put to use by the carpenter. And in the story, the word carpenter is spelled with a capital C, which suggests that it is Jesus, the master carpenter, who worked with everyone and continues to work with everyone for the building up of the kingdom of God. A similar approach is needed for education. Education and the education of our children will only succeed if government, private sector, NGOs, including church, and all stakeholders work together for the good of the development of our children and the building of our nation. Such cooperation and collaboration is required with the accompanying spiritual characteristics of covenant, obedience, and service. Because by working together, we are able to affirm your theme, acknowledging the foundation, continuing the legacy, building for the future. This means to embrace the past, celebrate the present, and look forward to the future. I won't be here for the next 280 years, but I guarantee you, if we do our part in continuing to build on the foundation and the legacy that we have received, the future under God is guaranteed. Congratulations on your anniversary. God bless you for the future. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I invite you to stand if you're able. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He
He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray. O God of infinite mercy, who has extended compassion to all persons, hear the prayers of your servants who are unworthy to ask any petition for themselves, yet are duty-bound to pray for others. Let your mercy descend upon your church. Preserve her in peace and truth, in unity and service, that her sacrifice of prayer and thanksgiving may ever ascend to your throne. In Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. After the bidding, Lord, as you give yourself for us, your response shall be, let us give ourselves to you.
Let us give ourselves to you.
We pray for the nation. Almighty and everlasting God, we praise you for all that you have done for us as a nation. Deepen the root of our national life in your everlasting righteousness, lest your blessing be withdrawn. Make us equal to our high trust, reverent in the use of freedom, just in the exercise of power, and generous in the protection of weakness. Inspire the men and women who direct the affairs of the nation. Give insight and faithfulness to our legislators and judges. And may our deepest trust ever be in you. Lord, as you give yourself for us,
let us give ourselves to you.
We pray for those who suffer. We give thanks for the passion and cross of our Lord, for the gift of redemption. We pray for all troubled souls, those anxious about their health or their future. We remember all who are being persecuted for their belief or their principles. Lord, as you give yourself for us,
let us give ourselves to you.
We pray for our schools and colleges. O eternal God, bless all schools, colleges, and universities that they may be lively centers for sound learning, new discovery, and the persistence of wisdom. And grant that those who teach and those who learn may find you to be the source of all truth. Lord, as you give yourself for us,
let us give ourselves to you.
We offer thanksgiving for 280 years. Lord, our God, who sustained us for these 280 years, we offer our grateful thanks to your guidance and providence that has led to our growth. Strengthen us as we journey ahead in faith, striving for excellence in the classroom, on the field, and in our daily lives. We call to remembrance all those who have graced the hallowed ground of Ravensworth over these 280 years. Students, teachers, friends, and all who serve the institution. We commend into your hands, O Lord, those who have died. Grant them eternal rest. Those who are in retirement, health, comfort, and peace. Those who are still active, a renewed vision as we recommit to nation building. Lord, as you give yourself for us,
let us give ourselves to you.
We pause to acknowledge those among us celebrating significant milestones in their lives.
And herein we give God thanks for Colette Furtado Price, principal of St. Jago, celebrating her birthday today. For Myrtle Gutsmore and Lesmin Smalling, celebrating 92 years each. For Paulette Josephs, Mario D'Souza, Dr. Kirk Green, Kerry Francis, Winsome Keen Dawes, Paula Riley, Viola White, Medlin Sutherland, Joyce Cunningham, Melva Jones, Ashley Smith, Marjorie Lewis Deuce, and Alyssa Lisian Riley, celebrating birthdays during the course of the week. Remember and celebrate also with Ronald and Evadne Watson, celebrating 65 years of marriage. And even as we celebrate, remember those who are bowed down because of illness and find it hard to celebrate. So remember those who are sick. Pearl Mullins, Lloyd Harrison, Lovina Bahadur, Peter Raymond Mullings, Medlin Sutherland, Constancia Ashley, Lilith Kidd, and John Castle. Remember those families that are in mourning. Remember those who have died. Noel Anderson, Mita D'Souza, Leonard Lawrence, Leon Harrison, Albert Adams, and Hubert Lawrence. Lord, as we give ourselves to you,
let us give ourselves to you.
We pray for the Boys and Girls Championship. We commend into your hand, O Lord, all the athletes and coaches, medical personnel, security personnel, providers of food, and all who shall be engaged in the safe and fair staging of the championship. As we celebrate with St. Jago High School on the occasion of their 280th anniversary, strengthen their limbs, increase their courage, and may these games be a source of greater delight in our celebration. Lord, as you give yourself for us,
let us give ourselves to you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, the fountain of all wisdom, enlightened by your Holy Spirit those who teach and those who learn, that rejoicing in the knowledge of your truth and attaining the maturity you will for all persons, they may worship you and serve you from generation to generation, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The act of penitence in the order of service. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins
cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We now go into a period of silence, and I invite you in this silence to think about the things you have said or done wrong, and you want to confess them to God. Let us therefore confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit. Usually we would shake hands and so on during the peace, but we don't because COVID is still around. So you can wave or nod or make some gesture without physical contact. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace.
Please be seated. At this time we have an offering in the form of a dance. You notice I say it's an offering. It is part of our offering in this act of worship. Are the dancers ready? I have not seen. Oh, here they come.
not Buddha nor Muhammad, but it's Jesus we cry out loud. Father, just forgive us, hear us when we say, we'll give you, give you, give you everything, our lives and souls today.
City.
Those who are able, you're expected to be standing at this time. Please stand.
Father, we offer to you these gifts which you have given us.
This bread, this wine, this money. With them, we offer ourselves, our lives and our work, to become, through your Holy Spirit, a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love. Through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. For you bid your faithful people cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that, fervent in prayer and in works of mercy, and renewed by your word and sacraments, they may come to the fullness of grace, which you have prepared for those who love you. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and glorious Father, our Creator God, we give you thanks because in your loving wisdom you brought all things into being and are truly worthy of praise from every creature you have made. Again and again we have turned away from you, yet in every age your steadfast love has called us to return to live in union with you, for it is your eternal purpose to put new life into all things and to make them holy. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, who took our human nature upon him, you have redeemed the world from the bondage of sin. By the power of your Holy Spirit, you have gathered a people to yourself to make known in every place his perfect offering which he made to the glory of your name. Hear us, therefore, Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that these gifts of bread and wine may be unto us his body and blood. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me."
Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. And so, Heavenly Father, rejoicing in his holy incarnation, his blessed passion and his perfect sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection from the dead, his glorious ascension into heaven, and looking for his coming in glory, we offer to you this bread and this cup. We pray that you will accept the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Grant that all who eat and drink of the body and blood of your Son, our great High Priest, may be renewed by your Holy Spirit and be one body, one spirit in heaven. Let faith and love increase in us. Unite us with Howard and all bishops, all of the ministers of your word and sacraments, and with the whole people of God, living and departed, whom you have made for yourself. Confirm us in holiness, that we may be found ready to join the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Blessed James, the Holy Apostles, and all your saints, when our Lord Jesus Christ comes again, forever giving you thanks and praise through him, from whom all good things do come. With him and in him and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven in songs of everlasting praise. As our Saviors taught us, so we pray. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
You take away the sin of the world.
the gifts of God for the people of God.
Our souls will feast and be satisfied, and we will sing God's songs of praise to Him.
Of Christ given for you.
Amen.
Word of Christ given for you. Word of Christ given for you. Word of Christ given for you. Word of Christ given for you.
You don't step down and thank you.
Let us pray. Please stand if you're able. Almighty Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May we who share his body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We upon whom your Spirit shines give light to the world. Help us to continue in faithful witness to your word, so we and all your children shall be free. And the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to sit for this selection by the choir, and I'll do the blessing later.
One, two.
Praise is what I do when I wanna be close to you. I lift my hands in praise. Praise is who I am. I'll praise. I'll bless you.
It's customary for me at this time to say good morning, but I had done that at the beginning of the service and welcomed you all, so I won't go through all of that again. But there are some domestic matters that we will have to take care of before we leave here. We're happy to have had the Bishop of Kingston, the Right Reverend Garth Minot, be our president and preacher at this grand celebration of 280 years of St. Jago High School. You'll be hearing much more about St. Jago in a little while, but by way of local affairs, I just want to invite Dene Clark. We all know Dene. Dene was born here and has been living here ever since. Unlike some other people I know, and that other person who I'm talking. Dene? Dene has been crowned Miss Culture Queen at her school, Angels Primary. We want to congratulate Dene. This is not the first time, second or third time that Dene is standing here receiving our commendation, because Dene has always been engaged and she has always done well. Long before she was crowned Culture Queen, she has been our queen. And Dene knows that. I wish some other people would be sitting beside Dene regularly. And them other people know themselves. Right, Dene? You know who I'm talking, right? You don't know? It's okay, Dene. I won't say anything more about that. When you go home, ask Grandma and ask Mommy who Canon was talking about. Are you here? Okay. Thanks very much. Let's put our hands together for Dene. Thank you, darling. We have a couple other things. At this time, let me invite the chairman of the Board of Management, Ms. Lisa Grant, to bring greetings. Followed by, after the chairman has done her thing, I don't know exactly what she's going to do, but all kinds of things, then we will take Mrs. Skyers will do the regular notices, followed by the blessing, and then the school song and closing hymn. Just
start. Right Reverend Garth Minot, Bishop of Kingston. Very Reverend Canon Colin Reed, Rector and Mrs. Reed. Canon Charles Manderson, Reverend Father Courtney Carides. Counselor Dr. Court Wall, representing His Worship, the Mayor, Counselor Norman Scott. Mrs. Sophia Forbes Hall, Regional Director, and Mr. Hall. And other representatives of the Ministry of Education and Youth. Members of the Board of Governors, Principal Mrs. Colette Price, past principals, Mr. Keith Noel and Mrs. Noel, esteemed past student, and Mrs. Sandra Swy Watson, Mrs. Victor Edwards, distinguished past students, parents, students, brothers and sisters in Christ, a glorious St. Jago morning to all. Firstly, let me tender an apology for our principal, Mrs. Collett Price. You would have seen her earlier, but she had to leave us a bit early to attend to national duties. We're sorry that she had to go. As you've heard before, today is her birthday, and we would have welcomed the opportunity to wish her happy birthday as a family. While this is not a vote of thanks, I would like to sincerely thank Bishop Garth Minot, who graciously and unhesitatingly agreed to preside and celebrate this significant event in the life of our school, and for his poignant and inspiring message. And Bishop, I am happy that you said there was no consultation, because as I heard you speak, I got very concerned that I would have to rewrite what I've written. But as Mrs. Swire Watson said, the spirit moves. Although I am certain Canon will say this is not necessary, since the cathedral is our home, I do wish to thank the clergy and members of the cathedral congregation for embracing us so warmly. 5 years ago, I stood at this very spot as we heralded the 275th anniversary of our great school. Today, I am both honored and humbled to stand with you and celebrate our 280th year. And what a way and a place for this to happen. In the shades of ancient Santiago Old Mother Church, reminding us of the enduring values that our school, emerging from the Anglican Church, has been built on. This is the legacy on which we stand. Unlike what was done for our 275th anniversary, I will not laud our school's accomplishments. Suffice to say, the legacy continues from this bastion of excellence that is St. Jago High School.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this very special anniversary broadcast with some items of breaking Ravensworth news. The achievements of St. Jago continue to set a legacy of excellence and greatness in all spheres. And of course, because this is St. Jago, we have quite a few items to get through. As the institution celebrates 280 years, this academic year has seen the school continue to solidify its place in history with outstanding achievements in academics, the performing arts and literary arts, sports, and other areas. We begin with some news in robotics. The school entered two teams last month in the first Technology Robotics Challenge National Championship. Both teams placed in the top 20. The junior team won the Connect Award for outstanding outreach achievement and engagement in the preseason. Senior team captain Dejanay Hilton also won the Dean's List nomination and will represent Jamaica later this year at the global competition in Texas. St. Jago was the only school with multiple nominees who made the Dean's List, which is the highest award in recognition of individual student achievement in robotics. Now on to TVJ's School's Challenge Quiz. Seven-time title holder and current defending champion St. Jago is now in the semi-final stage of the competition and will meet Jamaica College tomorrow in the final of three games. St. Jago needs to win and will win the match in their bid to secure the 8th SCQ Championship title. Now on to literary arts. Ricky Nicole Powell in sixth form was second in the County of Middlesex for the Jamaica Deposit Insurance High School Essay Competition. Now on to the Scientific Research Council's National Essay Oratory and Public and Performing Arts Poster Competition. Sasania Roy from fourth form was shortlisted with an entry which stood out among the many submissions. Her essay has been given the accolade of moving on to the archery component of the competition, and we salute her for that. Now let's head to sports. At the recent Central Track and Field Championships, St. Jago boys placed first. You heard right, first, and the girls came second overall in that event. Now on to Gibson relays. The boys were first in the class 1 and 3 4x100 meters relays, second in the class 3 4x200 meters relay, and second in the class 4 4x400 meters relay. Now on to the girls' side, St. Jago was first in the class 3 4x200 meters and the 4x200 meters open. The ladies were second in the class 2 4x100 meters relay. Now as the teams prepare to roll into the Issa Grace Kennedy Boys and Girls Championships, they are expected to deliver their usual outstanding performance as the only co-ed school in the past two decades to secure top 5 places in both girls and boys competitions. And this year is expected to be no different as they compete this week. Of course, you can catch the action live on TVJ, TVJSN, TVJ International in the Cayman Islands, and online at onespotmedia.com from anywhere in the world. Now still on track and field, 10 of St. Jago's student athletes, 3 boys and 7 girls, made the 2024 CARIFTA team. They will represent Jamaica in Grenada from March 30 to April 1. And of course in chess at the National Chess Championships, an incredible young chess team placed second in this year's staging. They retained the title of Best Rural School. Kofi Sutherland received the prizes of Best Board 2 and Nathaniel Hope of Best Board 3. National Age Group Chess Championship saw 3 St. Jago students, Michael Baker, J. Lloyd Chin, and Nathaniel Hope, tied for 5th place with 4 points from 6. Jaden Forshaw, a third form student, won the under 16 section and will represent Jamaica in a tournament overseas later this year. St. Jago continues to perform well in netball and football, and stakeholders have commended the teams in their efforts, and we do so today. Now in volleyball, the boys successfully defended the number one spot in the Central Zone Finals, winning 3-1 against Arakobesa High School. The girls placed second against Knox College 3-2, and the boys will meet Jamaica College in the All-Island Final at GC Foster College on March 26. For table tennis, the under 19 girls team are now through to the semifinals of the competition. Unfortunately, the boys did not advance, but we still celebrate them in their performance of excellence. St. Jago was the 2023 under 16 All-Island champions. And finally, in cricket, the under 19 team has advanced to the final of the Issa Grace Shield competition for the second consecutive year after defeating Kingston College by 5 wickets, the second win against them this season. The road to the final saw the Ravens winning 9 of 10 games and drawing 1 due to rain. Of course, we know if it did not rain, St. Jago would reign supreme. Now, St. Jago meets Excelsior High in the finals on March 27. Now, as I get the wrap-up signal from my producer at this time, I'm sure you know those of us who are Ravens and those who are Raven adjacent. We understand that those are just a few of the achievements so far in the 280th year of our school as we continue to fly the flag of excellence high. Of course, we will continue to monitor the happenings at Ravensworth and bring you all the reasons why this institution is still number one. I am Javon Keys with your breaking Ravensworth news. Now back to our lead anchor and school chair, Lissa Grant.
Thank you, sir. What I will do briefly with your indulgence is to acknowledge that this celebration really is to honor those who have gone before. Those who over these 280 years have made this occasion not only possible, but deeply meaningful. We honor our past. It shapes who we are now and what we will become. This is the legacy on which we stand. Accordingly, I would like to recognize by asking to stand past students of Cathedral High and Beckford and Smith. Please stand. Stand, mommy. Past students of St. Jago High School, please keep standing. Former board members, former principals and members of staff, current board members, our current principal and team priceless, our academic and ancillary staff. And most importantly at this time, the amazing current student body. Please stand. I wish you could see them. They're beautiful. Friends, I proudly present the true representation of our theme, acknowledging the foundation, continuing the legacy, building the future. This is the legacy on which we stand. Mr. Noel, over to you.
St. Jago. St. Jago. St. Jago.
Thank you. Please be seated. By remembering, we encourage, we inspire others to continue the work. By remembering, we know that great things are possible. This is the legacy on which we stand. It is therefore our collective hope that this celebration will bring with it renewed energy to move forward to even greater heights that will benefit our school. Inspired by the legacy of those who went before and motivated by those who follow, this is the legacy on which we stand. So today, we come together to make something greater than the sum of its parts. This is the legacy on which we stand, those who God calls, God sends. So seek to serve and to build up. God strengthens and inspires so that our efforts will be a blessing to our school, to our community, to Jamaica, and to the world. This is a legacy on which we stand to the glory of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. I would like to add here that this greeting was inspired to honor the memory of our dearly departed brother and friend, Super Raven Hubert Lawrence. While we await necessary arrangement and recognize the need to honor his family's requests, I wish to inform you that there is a mounted display and video presentation in the school library, which we invite you to visit and view. The contribution of Mr. Javon Keyes, who was mentored by Hubert, among others, as they formed the first media group at St. Jago, and now a well-recognized sport and newscaster in his own right, is also homage to Hubert. Thank you, Mr. Keyes. I have been contacted by ISSA in their effort to seek permission from Hubert's family for a special recognition of him at Boys and Girls Championships this week. And I'm also advised that our champs team will wear black ribbons during the opening ceremony to honor Hubert's memory. We also understand that on the final day of championships, during the broadcast, a special tribute involving our school to honor Hubert's memory will be presented, and I will say no more excepting stay tuned. May his soul rest in peace and light perpetual shine upon him. Thank you.
Mrs. Darling.
Good morning, everyone. I don't know how I can beat that, but it is my task to give the official welcome from St. Jago High School. And as the board chair said this morning, we are in the holy place of the Cathedral of St. Jago de la Vega. And any St. Jago student or past student would know of the church as the old mother church in our school song. So this morning we are home. And on behalf of the St. Jago High School family, I wish to welcome, as Kenan had said before, the Right Reverend Bishop Garth Minot, who was our preacher this morning, as well as his wife, Regional Director of the Ministry of Education, Region 6, Ms. Sophia Forbes Hall, and her husband, the representative from the St. Catherine Municipality, Dr. Kurt Wall, our chairman, and other members of the Board of Governors, former principal Mr. Keith Noel and his wife, Ms. Dorothy Noel, and daughter Tamara Noel, who are past students, former principal Mrs. Sandra Swire Watson, also a past student, former vice principal Mrs. Ardeen Jones, also a past student, wife of past principal Mr. Victor Edwards, that's Mrs. Edwards, specially invited guests, which include our past students, our teachers and support staff, our past teachers, our parents, members of the PTA executive, our students, and those persons who have joined us online. We would also like to acknowledge Canon and the team of priests who are here, as well as the congregation. A lot of people don't realize the support that we have gotten over the years from the cathedral, and we greatly appreciate that we were offered the opportunity this morning to share in our celebration of 280 years. As we give God thanks, we ask for your continued support. We thank God for blessing us and guiding us. And we invite you to participate in our upcoming events. You would see that listed at the back of your program, or you can visit our website, stjago.com, for further details. It has been a wonderful worship experience, and I can only say that we continue to grow from strength to strength. Thank you so much to the cathedral, our family, for your support.
Thank you, Mr. Stagger.
Good morning, church. Though I'm no athlete, I feel as if we're running a little relay, past student to past student, and it's a good feeling. Our birthday celebrants for this week are today, March 17th, Mrs. Myrtle Gutsmore, Mrs. Paulette Josephs, Mr. Mario D'Souza, and Mrs. Colette Furtado Price. On March 18th, Dr. Kirk Green, Miss Paula Riley, Mr. Carey Francis, Mrs. Winsome Keen-Dawes. On March 20th, Mrs. Joyce Cunningham, Mrs. Leslyn Smallin, and Miss Alyssa Riley. On the 21st, Mrs. Viola White. The 22nd, Mrs. Medlin Sutherland. And on the 23rd, Miss Ashley Smith, Mrs. Marjorie Lewis Dowse, and Mrs. Melva Jones. Can we sing happy birthday for them?
Happy
And still celebrating, we say congratulations and happy wedding anniversary to Ronald and Evadne Watson, who on March 21st will celebrate 65 years of marriage. As we pray during the course of this week, let us remember those families who have lost loved ones. And we remember especially the family of Mita D'Souza, who will be laid to rest tomorrow, Monday, March 18th. And the service will be here at the cathedral at 10 a.m. We also remember the family of Noel Anderson, who will be laid to rest on Saturday, March 23rd. And that funeral service here at the cathedral at 10:30. Also, the family of Leonard Lawrence, who will be laid to rest also on Saturday, and that service will be at 1:30 in the afternoon. We also pray for Kyle White, who will be traveling to Spain to participate in the Real Madrid World Challenge Youth Soccer Tournament. We pray that Kyle will do well and come back to us safely. Mrs. Deborah Davidson, our organist, would like to thank cathedral members for their prayers, phone calls, messages while she was ill. She's much better now, here with us this morning, and she just wants you to know that she appreciates your support. The cathedral requires the services of a janitor, and that is a full-time job here at church. The requirements are posted on our notice board, and you can make your application in writing to the people's warden. Our Lenten Fish Fest is scheduled for this Friday, March 22nd. And meals are served between the hours of 11 and 4. Persons are asked to, when they're coming to collect their meals, please walk with your tickets so that we can have a smooth transition. Next Sunday, March 24th, is our Palm Sunday service, and we begin at 8 at the Sagicor Plaza. And we will join in procession with the Methodist Church and the Catholic Church, and we march to Cathedral Square. The Women's Auxiliary members are being asked to meet on the south side for a very brief meeting immediately after service. Have a great day, brothers and sisters.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Kyles. And I just want to make sure we know who Kyle White is. Kyle is the son of Rochelle. Rochelle, son of, see, yes. Right, so we know who Kyle is now. And Kyle can't be going to Spain. He's going to Spain. Wow. I ask your prayers for Kyle. He seems to be doing some great things. Is going to participate in a significant event, the Real Madrid World Challenge Youth Soccer Tournament. He's our champion already. Please stand for the blessing.
Pray. Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross, and follow him. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you this day and forevermore.
St. Jago High School song.
Born in the shades of ancient Santiago, old Mother Church, our school still lives and toils. Proudly to serve and serving to enlighten darkness that hinders, ignorance that spoils. Stand we today where others stood before us, faithful, united, burning with a flame, fire that shall purge the evil things around us, fire that shall cleanse our island home from blame. Healthy in mind and vigorous in body, to follow in their footsteps, to work and
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Go now in peace to love and serve the Lord and each other. In the name of Christ, amen.